In this video, we will demonstrate the new feature in Windows 8 called the Charms Bar, and look at the individual charms located there. To expose the bar, just move the cursor to the upper right-hand corner. Or you can move it to the lower right-hand corner. On the desktop view, you can do the same thing. Move to the upper right-hand corner, or the lower right-hand corner. Now let's take a look at the individual charms. The top charm is for searching. When we click on it, we can search for apps, settings, files, as well as many other options. The next charm is for sharing. Notice that sharing is not available on the desktop side. However, if we switch to the Metro view, we see that sharing is available. This is limited to certain tiled Metro apps, such as Internet Explorer or email. We don't have anything to share on this PC right now. The next charm reopens the most recently viewed app. In our case, that is the desktop view. Clicking on it again displays the Metro start screen. The next charm is for devices. This is where printers, scanners, and other devices would be listed. If you have a second monitor, it would also be here. Finally, we have the settings charm. Here we can change settings for wireless connections, sound, brightness, notifications, as well as ways to shut down the computer. You might ask, is there an easier way to show the charm bar? The answer is yes. Just press the Windows and C keys to immediately show the bar. This also works on the Metro side. Press the Windows and C keys, and the bar immediately appears. Now let's return to the desktop. Let's say we want to go directly to one of the search functions. Press the Windows and Q keys to go directly to the apps search. If we press the Windows and F keys, we go to the file search. Finally, pressing the Windows and W keys takes us directly to the settings search. Let's switch to the Metro side and press the Windows and H keys to go directly to the sharing panel. The Windows and K keys open the devices panel. Finally, the Windows and I keys open the settings panel. So now you know the various ways to work with the new Charms feature in Windows 8. We will cover each of the charms in more depth in future videos. I hope that you found this tip helpful. This is just one of many videos about Windows 8 that we'll be producing. If you'd like to get a quick start, we have a free gift for you. Just click on the link below this video and you'll gain instant access to this quick reference card on handy Windows 8 shortcuts. Until next time, I'm Dick Buchanan with ByteSavvy Computing Services.